समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानालय करुणालय नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणो विदाति पूर्वं यो वेदान् यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदांश प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुहि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायन्ति संसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तोर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। नमः श्री शिव नमः। जस्ट अ मोमेंट, सम चेंजेस इन विंडोज आल्सो। So we are beginning with the, resuming with the 58th sutra of the third pada of the third adhyaya. So here the Sangati says, Purvam yatha vyasto upastishu vidishruti nam sattve api samasto upastir eva jayastva muktam. So what was done earlier? In the earlier adhikarana we had seen that the samasta upasti is jayaha, is better, is superior, shreshta also, compared to a vyasta upasana. So if there is upasana which is mentioned across shakhas or in the same shakha across places, which has a single phala, similar gunas are there, some gunas are different, then all of these gunas should be put together and instead of a vyastha upasana, samastha upasana should be done. Because the vidhi is of the same upasana across shakhas or across places. So purvam yatha vyastha upastishu vidhishruti nam sattve api, although there is vidhi of a particular upasana, it appears to be a particular separate upasana, but it is a single upasana. There is eka vakyata, even if it is across shakhas. Therefore, samasta upasthir eva jayastu muktam. The samasta upasana, combination of the upasana, all the gunas being clubbed together is jayaha. This was stated, established by the Siddhanti. Now, tatha, similarly Purvapakshi says, tatha eka upasaka upastishu pratyekam vidhinam sattve api samasta upastireva jayastum iti nasti vidyanam bhedaha iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Purvapakshi takes cue from Siddhanti's analysis and says that even if there are vidhis of a particular upasana such as dahara vidya or Shandilya Vidya, where the gunas are different, phala may or may not be same. There may be some overlap in phala, but some other phala may be there. Gunas are different, the name itself is different. So we have seen there are various cues or various parameters to be considered before clubbing together the upasanas. Purvapakshi says that just like you have analyzed and put together upasanas across shakhas, why consider various upasanas at all? All the upasanas can be clubbed together. Dhara Vidya and Shandilya Vidya also can be clubbed together. Why not do that? So pratyekam vidhinam satyapi, although there is a particular vidhi of a particular upasana like Dhara Vidya or Shandilya Vidya, which is a separate upasana, why should you keep it separate? Even if it is an individual viji, still what? Tatha eka upasya ka upasthishu. Where the upasya is one, you can club them together, says the Purvapakshi. Samastha upasthereva jayastvam. Clubbing together all upasanas such as Dhara Vidya and Shandilya Vidya together is Shrestha, is superior. Iti nasti vidyanam bheda. Therefore, there is no difference in any upasanas. This is what the Purvapakshi is claiming now. And thereby, we had seen in 3.1.1, we had seen Sarva Vedanta Pratyam Chodanadya Visheshat. We had seen is all the Vedanta Upasanas have a single Upasya, which is Parabrahma really. Whether it is called as Prana or Akasha Ityadi, it is still the same Upasya. This is what we have ourselves established. But the various Upasanas, how the Upasana has to be done is different with the Nama Bheda also. Prana Upasana is different. Dhara Akasha Upasana is different. Aditya Drishti has to be done. Such Upasanas are different. We have established difference also. But Purvapakshi is saying that let's club together all these upasanas, because finally the upasya is one and the same entity, as Vedanta agrees. You yourself agrees. You the Siddhanti, says the Purvapakshi. Therefore, Vidyanam Bhedha Nasti. Vidyanam Madhye Bheda Eva Nasti. This is what the Purvapakshi is taking as an example from the earlier Adhikarana and exemplified as all upasanas, whereby upasya is same and you club the gunas together. Siddhanti does not agree, and thereby Shabdadi Bhedadi Karanam comes up, in which the sutra is Nana Shabdadi Bhedat. Nana Shabdadi Bhedat. So Nana, upasanas are Nana. Why? Various. Nana means various. They are various. There are various upasanas. Saguna Brahma upasanas are separate. Although Saguna Brahma is one, manifestation of Saguna with various gunas are different. Just like in Smartha Karma also, in Smriti related bhakti or whatever you see, there are so many differences. There are so many differences in devatas, in the manifestation of the same Paramatma as what? As Ishta Devata, as Kula Devata, which has created differences in Vaishnava and Shaivas, Ganapatyas, Devi Upasakas, so many differences are there. But do the Advaitin Smartas who follow the Shruti proper, do we say that there is difference between them? As in the end Upasya, is it really different? It is not. Paramatma appears with various forms across both genders to bless the bhakta the way it is ishta to the bhakta. However, we cannot just club the saguna vidya together, upasanas and puja vidhis together. What has to be offered to a particular devata can be offered only to a particular devata. If there is an Ugra Devata who needs a particular offering, you cannot give some Saumya Dravya to that Ugra Devata. It won't take. In fact, it will backfire. What has to be given to a Saumya Devata should be given to a Saumya Devata. What has to be offered to a Ugra Devata in a particular manner, it has to be offered only in that particular manner. The same Dravya should be offered. It cannot be different. We cannot club them together. Why so? Even the same Devata, when being praised with a particular stuti, their particular form should be invoked. It cannot be any other dhyana shloka with which you can offer the stuti. For a particular stuti, some rishi will have seen a particular form, therefore this stuti should be offered only in that form of the same deity. It cannot be from any other shrutis, dhyana, shloka. So many differences are there in the vidhi. Therefore, phala bheda will be there, nama bheda will be there, guna bheda will be there, upasana bhedas will be there. Although the final upasya is one and the same, manifested upasya is various. So shabdadi bhedat, what is the hetu for these upasanas to be different? Shabda is different and adipadena gunas are also different. So due to such bheda, due to such difference, phalam purvavat, what has been said earlier, as to here it is a little difficult to explain purvavat because immediate sangati with the earlier adhikarana won't work. So phalam purvavat has to be taken as appropriate, as fitting. Sorry, because what has been seen in the earlier adhikarana is Siddhanti is saying samasta upasana is jaya, and Purvapakshi is saying vyasta upasana should be done, whereas here it is exactly opposite. So phalam purvavat should be seen across adhikaranas. You should jump back a couple of adhikaranas or interpret appropriately crossing the Siddhanta Paksha and the Siddhanta Paksha and the Purva Paksha. Or Phalam Purvavat can be, although not appropriate, it can be read with the Sangati. What has been mentioned in the Sangati, that is the difference. Anyway, so because I have a question mark here, it is not explained how Phalam can be Purvavat. Santi Saguna Brahmaika Vidyaha Shandilyadi Vidyaha तथा एव मुख्य प्राण विद्या अपि. सो देर आर मेनी विद्यास विच आर वॉट मुख्य प्राण विद्या. मुख्य प्राण विद्या से प्राण इज इंटरप्रिटेड वेरियसली एज घ्राण इत्यादि. देन पंच प्राण भेद इज ए प्राण अपान व्यान उदान समान. और प्राण इज सीन एज इंद्रियाज ऑल्सो. देर फोर मुख्य प्राण शोज दैट इट इज नॉट एनी ऑफ द अदर मीनिंग्स. इट इज इन द सेम मीनिंग ऑफ प्राण, मुख्य प्राण, which is what keeps the jiva alive, that prana devata. And in, at samashti level also keeps the all the jivas alive, that is the mukhya prana. Outside it will be called as vayu. But when it enters the sharira, it will become prana devata, the same vayu. So there is vyashti and samashti aikya there. So such vidyas are there which help a person to see samashti and vyashti aikya. However, there are other ways also. Shandilyadi vidyas are there where saguna brahma aikya is vedya. What is to be known there? And not just knowing, vedya is there upasana. One has to do upasana on that. It is a saguna brahma, and that saguna brahma is one and the same across upasanas. So shandilyadi vidya also has. So Sandhyadi Vidyaha Adipadena, other Vidyas also Dhara Vidya Ityadi, where various words are used to explain the same Saguna Brahma, and it can be seen manifest in as manifest as Aditya or Akshipurusha or as in the Hridayakasha in Dhara Vidya Ityadi. Or tathayo mukhya prana vidya api. Mukhya prana vidya is also there, and mukhya prana vidya is nothing but parabrahma, saguna brahma itself. So upasya is one, but with various methodologies of upasanas with various names, the same saguna brahma is to be approached by various shakha followers through such upasanas. They are very particular upasanas. ताह किम नाना उत अभिन्ना इति विषये संशये सति. When there is a doubt as to whether these upasanas are different, as many as the upasanas, so many are the methodologies, and so many are the differences also, and they should be retained, therefore they are नाना upasanas उत अभिन्ना, or whether they are a single upasanas spread across, and therefore you should club them together. When such doubt comes up, पूर्व पक्ष इज वॉट अभिन्न इति पूर्व पक्ष. पूर्व पक्षी से इज दैट क्लब देम टूगेदर. यू कैन मिक्स अप मुख्य प्राण विद्या, शांडिल्य विद्या, धर विद्या, ऑल ऑफ देम टूगेदर, डू अ समुच्चय एंड देन डू उपासनास. वोंट वर्क. देर आर आई मीन इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फोकस ऑन मल्टीपल एरियाज. इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट एन अक्षिगत पुरुष यू कैनॉट हैव हृदयाकाश दृष्टि. सो इट इज नॉट चिंतना. सी इन चिंतना, इन वेदांत चिंतना, वन कैन लैंड ऑन वैक्य विच इज ब्रह्मात्मा थ्रू वेरियस वेज एंड मल्टीपल वेज कैन ऑल्सो बी देर. वेर एवर द माइंड रन्स यू कैन ब्रिंग इट बैक विद द ऐक्य विच वॉट एवर इज द विषय ऑफ इन द माइंड. वेदर इट इज सम उपास्य, सम इष्ट देवता और सम उपनिषद गत मंत्र और सम कर्मकांड गत विधि ऑल्सो इफ द माइंड रन्स देर विद ओल्ड संस्कार. और इट कैन बी लौकिक विषय ऑल्सो. समबडी इज थिंकिंग ऑफ विषय बट स्टिल इफ चित्त शुद्धि इज इनफ वन कैन एंड वन हैज अंडरस्टूड द तत्व वेल देन वन कैन ब्रिंग ऑल ऑफ दैट विद अ सिंगल स्टेप ऑल्सो. नॉट इवन मल्टीपल स्टेप्स. मल्टीपल स्टेप्स आर ऑल्सो पॉसिबल बट even with a single step one can come back to aikya. If the mind is running with the prapancha vishayas, then sarvam khalvidam brahma, oh all this is brahma, one can come back. Or ishavasyam idam sarvam, this entire prapancha is nothing but ishvara's manifestation, so one can come back and that is me. Therefore one can land in a couple of steps, one can land on aikya, whatever be the vritti vishaya. However, that is not possible in vidhi upasana. So, upasana vidhis, vidhi shrutis. When vidhi shruti is saying that this is how it has to be done, some kamya phala may be tied to it. There you cannot mix up. It has to be as per the vidhi. So, therefore, siddhantastu vidyaha nana eva bhinna eva. They are definitely different vidyas. Shandilya vidya is different from धर विद्या इत्यादि कुतः वायसो आस दि पूर्व पक्षी शब्दादि भेदात. बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंस इन शब्द एटसेट्रा. व्हाट इज दैट? वेद उपासीत क्रतुं कुरुवीत इति शब्द भेदात. आदि पद मीन्स आदि शब्देन उपास्य गुण भेदाच्च इत्यर्थः. व्हाई आर दीज उपासनास डिफरेंट? बिकॉज इन वन प्लेस द तिंगंत पद इज वेद. This is how it should be known. This is how it should be understood. This is how the methodology is. This is how the upasya should be meditated upon. So, Veda is a vidhi, which is different from upasita. The pada itself is different. The vidhi is different. Upasita, do the upasana in this manner. Kratum kuruita, this is how the kratu. So, there may be some karma that one has done earlier in one's own shaka. This is how you imagine. We had seen some karmanga ashrita upasanas. There also the vidhi is different. So kratum kurvita, this is how you should do the kratu. It is like a karma vidhi. Karma cannot be mixed up. Upasana is karmanga ashrita. Angas cannot be mixed up. How can ashrita upasanas be mixed up? So all these words tell you that they are separate vidhis, completely separate vidhis. As we saw in bits of Artha Sangraha, the words Veda, Upasita, Kratum, Kurvita have so much, the Tinganta Pada has so much to create bhavana in the mind of the listener. So Shabdi Bhavana leading to Arti Bhavana are all different across the Tinganta Padas, Iti Shabda Veda. Therefore, Upasanas are different. Why? Because the words which are giving the vidhi, they themselves are different. Names are also different. Adi Shabdena, what about Adi Shabda Adi? Adi Shabdena, with the Adi word, what is meant is Upasya Guna Bhedaccha Ityartha. Because the gunas, the way in which the upasana has to be done, what all has to be imagined, all that is different. This is the 58th Sutra. The 59th Sutra introduction says, Purvatra Vidyananatve Siddhe Kila Ayam Vicharaha Pravartate Iti Hetu Hetu Madbhava Sangatya Idamaha. So there is a hetu hetumat bhav sangati between the earlier adhikarana and this adhikarana. The earlier adhikarana becomes the hetu for this adhikarana. Why? Because unless the earlier adhikarana is dealt with, you cannot go to this adhikarana, because there is a connection as to the earlier adhikarana establishing something itself will allow you to inquire into the next section, in the next adhikarana. So purvatra vidyananatve siddhe, only if the upasanas are established as different, saguna brahma upasanas are established as different, then alone you can do this vichara. What is the vichara? Whether the samuchaya of all these upasanas can be done, meaning yathaishta, not samuchaya, yathaishta. Samuchaya also, individual upasanas also. So this section that is coming up, which is vikalpadhikarana, has dependency in the earlier adhikarana, in that only if the upasanas are established as various, then alone you can ask a question and inquire as to which among these upasanas should be done by the sadhaka. Should he do dhara upasana? Should he do shandilya vidya? Should he do mukhya prana upasana? Purva pakshi se yatheshta. Whatever, you know, whatever you want, you can do. You can club them together, you can club two together, you can mix and match. You know, you have so many permutation combinations, you can pick one, yatheshta, or you can pick multiple, you can mix and match. All sorts of arrangements are possible, because pravruttis are different. So he says, you can do that in Saguna Brahma Upasana. So this is what the Purvapakshi is saying. Just give me one moment. So here in this Saguna Brahma Upasana, finally what is being done? Ahangraha is, it is an Ahangraha Upasana. So in the, only if the Vidya Nanatva is established, then only one can have Ahangraha, meaning I am this Mukhya Prana. Finally, this prana, who is this prana? I am that. That Adityagata Purusha, who is that Adityagata Purusha? It is the same jiva, which I am, who is seen in the eyes. When the Chitta Shuddhi is sufficient, the Shraddha is sufficient, the Upasana is done properly, then there is a vision of the jiva in the eyes, which is called Akshigata Purusha. So that Akshigata Purusha, who is me, has the same name and characteristics as the Adityagata Purusha, Hiranyasmasura Ityadi, that we had seen. The golden hue, the golden hair, mustache, beard, etc. All this, whatever has been imagined, golden hair and golden skin, etc. It is the same Purusha who is Aditya Antargata as well as Jiva, Deha Antargata, Akshi Antargata Purusha. This is what the understanding is finally. And who is that I am? So Ahantvena, it is to be seen as oneself. This is the final step in all these Upasanas, which is called as Ahangra Upasanas. So this Ahangra Upasanas, finally, because one is to take that Upasya as oneself, there is an Aham Drishti in that Upasya, Purvapakshi says, you can mix and match, or you can have Vikalpa, you can take your choice, your pick, do any of these Upasanas. Siddhanti says that, no, these are separate Upasanas, although there is Ahangraha, Ahangraha cannot be in the Aditya as well as Prana at the same time. So you cannot club them together. You can pick one Upasana and stick with it. It will give the same phala. Finally, Ahangraha Upasana will give the same phala. Chitta Ekagrata and the phala also mentioned. Finally, there is merging in the DT, which is what is expected. So you stick to this. Stick to the Upasana. Pick one and stay with it. So there is no permutation and combination that needs to be done. One can pick one and stay with it. This is the Siddhanta Paksha. So Vikalpa, there is an option of picking any of these. Whereas Purva Paksha says Yatheshta, you can pick one or you can pick two. You can just mix and match. You can यू नो डू वॉट एवर यू लाइक, दैट इज नॉट हाउ दी उपासना वर्क सेज द सिद्धांति. सो पूर्वत्र विद्यानानात्वे सिद्धे किल अयम विचारः प्रवर्तते. दिस इंक्वायरी इनटू वेदर देर इज विकल्प और यथेष्ट ऑफ दीज उपासनाज दैट कैन बी डन ओनली इफ विद्याज आर मेनी. इफ द उपासनाज आर नॉट मेनी, इफ इट इज अ सिंगल उपासना देन वेर इज द ऑप्शन? देर इज नो ऑप्शन. देर फोर हेतु हेतु मत भाव संगत्या इदमाह विकल्पाधिकरण विकल्पो विशिष्ट फलत्वात् विकल्पो विशिष्ट फलत्वात्. सो विकल्प बाय अवशिष्ट अविशिष्ट फलत्वात् बिकॉज द फला इज अविशिष्ट. बिकॉज द फला इज अविशिष्ट देर इज फला मेन्शन विच अहंग्र उपासना. द फला इज मर्जिंग इन द डीटी विच इज फाइनली वॉट सगुण ब्रह्म. So all these ahangra upasanas have the same phala. So if you prefer one particular deity, one particular methodology of upasana, you can stick to it. You will get the same result as what the other is getting. Why would you mix up? There are two ways, three ways, four ways to reach the same place. Somebody prefers a highway. Another prefers a village road. He does not want to go on the highway, prefers, wants to avoid toll, whatever be the reason. So if you are a biker or you know, you want to take a vacation, you want to walk or whatever. So trekking also, you want to reach the peak, there are multiple paths. You can take, you know, take the road, take a vehicle. You can go to Tirupati, you can climb the steps. So these options are there. The final goal is what? Reaching the peak. The destination is reached by all these ways. Why would you mix up? You cannot say halfway through, okay, let me do this. You cannot switch. That is not appropriate. The same phala is there. Why would you mix them up? This is the question of the Purvapakshi. And he says there is no such, it makes no sense to mix up the upasanas when all upasanas, all these ahangra upasanas are leading to the avishishta phala, same goal. Therefore, vikalpa, there is option to pick one. Atra purvapakshe yatheshtam anushthanam iti aniyamaha. There is no rule which says you do this or you do that. There is a rule as to this is how you do it. This upasana has to be done in this way. But purvapakshi says there is no rule as to which upasana should be done by which sadhaka. There is no such rule as per the purvapakshi. Therefore, yatheshtam anushthanam. However one wants, one can do, one can stick to one, one can mix up also. Siddhante vikalpena anushthanam iti niyama iti phalaveda. Vikalpena anushthanam is a niyama. Siddhanti says there is a rule. You are following a particular shaka, there is an upasana given to your shaka, you stick to it. Why do you want to do somebody else's upasanas? Angra upasana. If you have the same upasana in another shaka, for example, let's say dahara upasana is given in your shaka. There is a dahara upasana in another shaka. Then those gunas you bring in and do the dahara upasana as described in your shaka, keeping your gunas and borrowing gunas from the dahara upasana only from the other shakas. If shandilya vidya is being given in your shaka, you do shandilya vidya. If some question is there as to some part is missing, you look up other, learn the other shakha antargata shandilya vidya and bring in the missing gunas from those and do the upasana of shandilya vidya. Why would you want to mix up dahara gunas into shandilya vidya? Or why do you want to switch and say, oh, let me, you know, try that also and then come back? Stick to one. If you want to do dahara vidya, do dahara vidya. If you want to do shandilya vidya, do that. So you are supposed to do a complete upasana, not bits and pieces of this upasana and see how that goes. It is not, you know, toe in the water kind of a test. It is a sadhana for finally purushartha siddhi. So stick to one upasana, do it complete. You can do another upasana later if you want. There is a vikalpa. So you see some phala is already attained, you feel that okay, I have so much of life left, what am I supposed to do? You can try another upasana after the upasti is krita completely, krita upasti, after you become krita upasti, you can switch and try another upasana also if you want. You have your Upasya Devata Darshana Ityadi, elsewhere it is talked about. So that means Upasana is complete. But if you look at these Shrauta Upasanas, they are till the end of the life. Entire Upasana has to be done. They'll say that for Krama Mukti, how to leave the body also will have been mentioned there. In some Upasanas, it will be discussed as this is how end, this is how you pray to the prana, or this is how you pray to Aditya. So all these Upasanas are to be done in particular manner, Ajivana, because finally these are for Krama Mukti. They are not going to give you Mukti here and now. They may give you some Ishta or Kamya Phala here, some of these Upasanas. But most of Ahangra Upasanas will give you merging with the deity, and if the drishti is that you are Parabrahma, then there can be Brahmaloka Gati also. So all these will lead to Krama Mukti after the drop of the body, so there is nothing else to do. So there is no mix and match there. Thereby, there is a Phalabheda. Yaha Saguna Brahma Vidyaha Vedya Sakshat Karena Phalahetavaha Kim Tasam Vikalpa Samuchaya Abhyam Anushtanam Uta Vikalpa Eva Iti Samshaye. When there is a doubt as to can these Saguna Brahma Vidyas, which are finally leading to Ahangra Upasana, Vedya Sakshatkarena Phalayetava. How are these Saguna Brahma Vidya, they are Phalayetava, meaning there is Phala, they are Hetu for Phala. What is the Phala? Vedya Sakshatkara is the Phala. The Vedya Upasya Sakshatkara takes place. Now when such kind of an arrangement is there as to Vedya Sakshatkara, Parabrahma Sakshatkara will take place, Kim Tasam Vikalpa Samuchaya Abhyam Anushtanam Uta Vikalpa. Whether one can pick one as well as mix up, meaning Yatheshta. Somebody wants to do multiple together, they can do multiple together. Somebody wants to do all together, he can do all together. Somebody wants to do only one at a time, he can do one at a time. Is that possible? Or Uta Vikalpa Eva, or should one stick to one pick among these and continue? When such doubt is there, Niyamaka Abhavat Svechya Eva Iti Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha is Svechya, you have free will, do whatever you want. You want this Upasana, you do it. But not only that, if someone else, you cannot say that someone else also should pick one and stick to it. He may want to do multiple, let him mix up. What is your problem? Won't work. It will not give you phala in that manner. Siddhantastu vikalpa eva asam vidyanam yuktaha. Logically, it makes sense to have only one vidya at one time and do it till Vedya Sakshatkara. Kutaha, why so? Yudhi Purvapakshiya Siddhanti se avishishta phalatvat. All of these Upasanas give the same phala. Vedya Sakshatkara akhya abhinna phalatvat ityartha. Ahangra Upasana will give you abhinnatvam. And abhinnata in phala between the Upasanas. Why? Because Vedya Sakshatkara will take place. And Vedya is Saguna Brahma Paramatma himself, seen as Prana or Aditya Purusha Ityadi, Dhar Akasha Antargata Purusha. All these are different ways to same to have Sakshatkara of the same Parabrahma Tattva, which pervades across. But it is not Aikya by understanding, which will be explained in the end of the in the Upanishads. In the Chandogya also, first five chapters are all these Upasanas. Karmangashrita Upasanas, then you have independent Upasanas, Karmash, then there are Ahangra Upasanas, Prana Upasanas, Mukhya Prana Upasanas, Aditya Upasana, all these. Then there are even some in the fifth chapter, I think there are some pariharas mentioned in karma also. In karma, if something has gone wrong, then what parihara? So there are some vyavrutis are mentioned, bhuva, suha, ityadi. These should be done. Ahuti should be given. How the upasaka should sleep? Where should he sleep? Where should he face sleeping? All this becomes part of this upasakas. It is not for the karmi, but this upasana also talks about some karma in the Upanishad proper. After the five chapters are over, 6, 7th, and 8th, we'll also have some Upasanas, but there is some Mahavakya Upadesha also, which is not there in the earlier. Earlier, five chapters of the Chandogya Upanishad, so for example, does not have Mahavakya Upadesha. There is Aikya Drishti, Ahangraha, all that is there, but it is all going to lead to Krama Mukti. It is not going to give you Mukti there and then and there. However, some Upasaka may have Vedya Sakshatkara and some Ekagrata and Chitta Shuddhi so much that he may have a thought as to, oh, if it is me, then why do I need to travel? Such kind of question may come up, and with such Chitta Shuddhi and with such inquiring mind, one may approach a guru to be taught Aikya. And if one settles down with Aikya Buddhi, then there will be Jivan Mukti here and now. There may be no necessity for the Upasaka to travel because he is no more an Upasaka. He is a Jinyasu. And that Jinyasu, if he understands the Mahavakya properly and sticks to the teaching, then it will lead to Jivan Mukti here and now. So coming back to our Upasana Kanda, Kutaha Avishishta Phalatva, there is Krama Mukti Phala or Vedya Sakshatkara merging with the deity after, or vision of the deity here, not the deity really, Saguna Brahma, in whichever manner it is discussed, Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya. So Vedyasya Upasyasya Sakshatkara Akhya is Abhinna. That is the phala. Akhya is what? Abhinnam phalam. That itself is there, and such Upasanas, all these Upasanas, Ahangra Upasanas, have what? Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya Abhinna Phalatvam. They have capacity to give the phala, which is Abhinna. And what is the Abhinnatvam? The Abhinnatvam is Vedya Sakshatkara, called as Vedya Sakshatkara. That is the Abhinnatvam. So this is how the Samasa works. Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya is Bahuri to Bhinna, Abhinna and Phala in Karmadharya. So Abhinna, Abhinnam Yat Phalam. That is what? Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya Yasya Abhinna Phalasya. That is what? Tat Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya Abhinna Phalam. And then Tasya Bhavaha Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya Abhinna Phalatvam. It is there in all of these Upasanas, Ahangra Upasanas. And that becomes the hetu as to Vedya Sakshatkara Akhya Abhinna Phalatvata Ityartha. It is the hetu for Vikalpa. One can do one of these Upasanas. Further, what? Purvam Ahangra Upasthinam Vikalpena Eva Anushteyatvam Abhani. This is what tells you that Ahangra mention is not here. You have to read further and come back. So Ahangra Upasthinam, these Upasanas which are being given as Vikalpa, they are all Ahangra Upasanas. One Upasaka should see the Upasya as oneself finally. Once one understands how the Upasana is, then finally he should see, oh, it is all me. This Upasya is me. There is no understanding. It is a Vidhi. Vidhi says that you see that Upasya, Prana, as yourself. Aditya, Akshigata Purusha, Aditya Gata Purusha as yourself. This is the Ahangra Upasana. Graha is grasping. Grasping is in the buddhi, you have to grasp, in the vritti, you have to grasp it as oneself. Oh, this is not with understanding, just because the vidhi says. Even if one thinks that, oh, I am not that deity, but one imagines oneness with that deity. So, Purvam Ahangra Upasthinam Vikalpena Eva Anushteyatvam Abhani. What has been stated, established is that there is Upasana following of these Ahangra Upasanas as a Vikalpa only, not Yatheshta. There is no mixing up or picking multiple or whatever what one wants, you cannot do that. Tadvad Upasthitva Avisheshat Pratika Upasthinam Api Vikalpena Eva Anushteyatvam Syadidi Drishtanta Sangatya Idamaha. Purva Pakshi says that then why not mix up Pratika Upasana also? See, Pratika Upasana is taking some Pratika. Pratika is some symbol. That it can be a visual symbol or it can be a sound symbol. In Omkara Ityadi, it is all sound symbol. Omkara is not to be विजुअलाइज्ड, इट इज नॉट अ रिटन ओमकारा, ओमकारा इज अ शब्द, शब्द इज हर्ड. सो द शब्द विच इज हर्ड इन पर्टिक्युलर उपासना एज ओम, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन उद्गीत उपासना पंचभाक्तिक सप्तभाक्तिक उपासना सॉरी सामस, इन पंचभाक्तिक सप्तभाक्तिक साम देर इज उद्गीत विच ऑकर्स इन अ पर्टिक्युलर प्लेस. इन बोथ ऑफ दीज इट ऑकर्स एट डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एज वन पार्ट. In that there is one omkara. That omkara is upasya as udgita itself, or something else, or something else. Such kind of vidhis are given across upasanas. So there, this that particular omkara alone will be seen. So omkaram udgita upasita. If that is a vidhi, then udgita buddhi, which is what in the avayava sama avayava. Udgita is there, Udgita Avayava Omkara is there. In that Omkara, which is Udgita Avayava, in the Avayava means Bhaga, part. In the part of the Udgita, which is part of Sama, Sama Mantra, in that there is an Udgita Buddhi, which is a Sama Bhaga Buddhi. So Sama Bhaga Buddhi, in Sama Bhaga Udgita Bhaga Omkara. That was the Vidhi there. So there is a Shabda Pratika there, that becomes a Pratika. Or what, for, like for Shivlinga, in Shivlinga, Shiva Buddhi, that is a Pratika, Pratika Upasana. Or you have Salagrama, in Salagrama, Vishnu Buddhi, all these are Pratika Upasanas. So in Pratika Upasanas also, Pratika, you take some Pratika. It can be Hridayakash also Pratika, it becomes Pratika, in which you visualize something. So visualizing something else which it is not in something, Purva Pakshi says Ahangra is what? Aham is different from the Vedya. So Vedya, in Vedya you are doing Aham Buddhi, and thereby you have clubbed together whichever different Vedyas are there, wherever Ahangra Buddhi is given, you are saying that there is Vikalpa. So why not have vikalpena anushtharam in pratika upasana also? Vikalpena eva anushtheyattvam syat iti drishtant sangatya. So in pratika I have given example, but pratika upasana in shrauta karma is particular. So we'll see why not have vikalpa, meaning stick to one. There is no reason for you to stick to one. If you look at in puja also, Advaitins follow Ishta Devata, they follow Kula Devata, and they then more also based on festivities, one can do more upasanas and pujas also. In Navaratri, Devi Puja. Across 9 days, various forms also. Not only Durga or Saraswati or only Lakshmi. There are various nine days, nine different forms are there. It is the same Paramatma. Then Ganesh Chaturthi, Ganapati Puja, Shivratri Shiva Puja. Then Krishnashtami Krishna Puja. All this can be done. Why should one stick to one? So Vikalpa. So there also in Pratika Upasana also there is no such reasoning to stick to one, says the Siddhanti. So thereby Kamya Adhikaranam comes up. See, Pratika Upasana is for Kamya Phala. Some Kamya Phala it will give you. Now these Kamya Phalas are different across different Upasanas. For example, there is a joke as to, I'm already late, we'll stop here, I'll not read the sutra, just let me put a note there as I'm running 5 minutes late for the next, I want to close this with some mention. Let me just say that I'm running 5 minutes late for the next part. WhatsApp is stuck. So, I just want to close this with a mention as to here in Pratika Upasana, some phala is given. This phala for a particular Upasana is wanted. Meaning a person is wanting. He's a wanting person. If Sadhaka is a wanting person, he is doing this Pratika Upasana for some phala. Some says that you will get putra. Some other says that you will get dhana. Some other says that you will get pashu. Pashu dhana. Whatever, putra is also dhana, pashu is also dhana. But there is dhana separate from this also. or one will get fame. So such upasanas may be there in across these pratika upasanas, different phalas are given. So whatever is the kamya phala, one may want multiple of these. So one may do multiple upasanas. Why should one have vikalpa and stick to only that vikalpa? Oh no, I should only do this because I want putra. But what about after getting putra, what about dhana? So for dhana, another upasana is needed. And while wanting the putra also, one may want dhana. So you can club them together. Club them together not in a single upasanas. You can do two different upasanas on the same day also, one after the other. There is no reason to not do other upasanas, stick to only one. So this is the Siddhanta. Purva Pakshi is saying that vikalpa. Pratika upasana also, in pratika there is a difference, the buddhi of something which is different. Shiva is not really the Shivalinga, but there is a Shiva buddhi adhyaropita on the Shivalinga. That is a pratika upasana. So if there is a superimposition being done, you can superimpose one deity on one. Similarly, upasana also, you have to have some kalpana of something as described in the vidhi, upasana vidhi, with a particular pratika. So you stick to one as earlier established by the Siddhanti. But that is not the case with kamya. Pratika upasanas are kamya. They give different results. Therefore, different results may be needed, may be wanted by same upasaka. So he will have to do those different upasanas. He cannot say that there is only vikalpa, I can do this or that. Time being limited, one can stick to one, but there is no reason to stick to one. With this Sangati, we'll stop and we'll continue with the next part. आनंद घनमापूर्णमात्म ज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद सिद्धेश पाठक
धन्यवाद नमस्ते।